Hey everyone, we're near the end of the 2025 HVAC Symposium this year down in Florida. And I'm here with the lovely Tyler Nelson.
Lovely.
Use that word.
Wonderful.
Very loosely. I'll take handsome. I'll take anything I can get at this stage. So we'll take it.
Good to see you, man.
Likewise. Thank you. So we're here at the Woodstock of HVAC events.
Basically, yeah.
Which is a wonderful event with all these like-minded souls.
Nerds.
And you came over and said, what is the latest and greatest on these analyzers, and refresh my memory. So that's what I'm going to do.
Yeah.
So we have two analyzers here. We have our 030, which is a residential light commercial model. And we have our 130, which is a residential commercial model. The 030, you can have it be equipped with NOx or add NOx to it. The 130, you can add NOx or low NOx to. So we have the differentiators as four buttons, color screen, full color touch screen. Now, what makes these things both similar is they're both on the measureQuick platform. They are both used by NCI exclusively in their trainings. So, love that times two. And both of them have longest sensor life in the industry, 5 years oxygen, 4 to 5 year sensor life for the CO, 4 to 5 year sensor life for the NOx or low NOx. So all have the longest sensor life across the board in the industry.
And when you say 4 to 5, does it tell you?
It does. So we have sensor life indicator for any sensor in this chassis.
Yeah.
So you can actually see how much sensor life you have left, but we don't stop there. Because you work for a living, we assume you're going to forget to look at that like the absent-minded professor. We have eyes in the back of your head. So we also have an end-of-life indicator, which has an algorithm that reads the performance of the sensor combined with its age and its hours of usage, and will trigger a notice on your screen when the performance starts to wane. So when it starts to wane, it will say, oxygen sensor, CO, NOx, whatever it might be, is approaching its end of life.
Early warning.
Exactly. With enough notice, where it's not going to die in you right then and there, with enough notice to react, order yourself and install the sensor, or even better yet, send it in for service, if need be, and get it in for service and calibration. Yes, sir.
So when it comes to installing a sensor, what's that process look
Very easy. This one here, the 030, the oxygen sensor is replaceable. The CO and the NOx would come back to the office, because it's a more of a, not a base model, but that's the model, the way we designed it. Every sensor in this chassis is field replaceable, pre-calibrated. But simply done, unscrew it, and there's a series of 4 or 5 screws in there. Unscrew, pop the sensor out, pop it back in. It'll calibrate itself, you fire it back up, and you're good to go.
I'd love to have that type of optionality, where I can just pop it in whenever I want. I love having my tools, but I get a little nervous. Gotta send it away.
Yeah.
Without it for a while, feel naked.
Yes, and because it makes your money and keeps you safe. Yeah. And it's an important tool, especially for people that are here. They know the importance of great tools.
Yeah.
In addition to all those features, the CO sensor, 8,000 PPM, highest out there. We don't stop there. Programmable pump cutoff. So when I train, part of the diagnostic training is to train at light off, which means things become very erratic, which means it's easy to overrange a CO sensor. That won't happen with this. You control the pump level when you want it to cut off. So you will never saturate the CO sensor unless you turn the feature off and you hit 10,000, then you're going to saturate it. But if you keep the feature on, you will never oversaturate the sensor. You're not going to kill it. You're able to test and test at will, which means testing in the most rigorous of environments.
You
have that.
Stupid proof to some degree.
Right. And for those that really want to drill down on this, up to 5 different parameter alarms that you can set for min or max. So if you're working on a setup of a piece of equipment and you want to know when you've hit certain points, if you want to stop adjusting, you'll have a visual alert of when you hit that threshold that you created yourself. Cracked heat exchanger test or heat exchanger integrity test is built into here. So we have that. Does draft, does gas pressure. Yep. So it has all that. We also have a separate probe setup where if you want to do draft and combustion simultaneously the entire time, that's what NCI uses in their trainings, that separate draft probe. So we have that. And firmware updates are very easy. You don't have to send it back to us. We're not going to keep it like we're trying to keep a baby to full term. You can do it yourself. Keep the baby yourself. Do the firmware updates either over the app for this one or over your phone, and also through PC software, or for this over your phone on that one there with the app.
Bluetooth,
yeah. Yes. Which means you do not have to be on anybody's Wi-Fi, because given all security protocols, even with individual households, you're not hopping anybody's Wi-Fi. You have Bluetooth there.
Yeah.
So you have that. And long life lithium ion batteries, so you have plenty of life to be able to actually do your testing. And when it comes to service, fastest out there, maximum 5 days in season. In mid-May to mid-August, 1 to 2 days.
Where does it get shipped to?
Yardley, Pennsylvania.
Okay.
So right in PA.
Yeah, and then just basically a day turnaround kind of thing. That's once it runs.
Yep, a couple days, a day to a couple days, depending on the nature of the season, but maximum 5 days. So, yeah, so these have done obviously very well in the space. We have a nice following with people like yourself, but also others in the industry that take their testing very seriously. And we're in a crowded space with very wonderful competitors and all great products out there. But to have the NCI usage and to be on measureQuick, he is. And those, to me, if I was an outsider looking in and trying to study the industry, those seem to be the most influential endorsements that you can get, which means you have chops. And that's all we want to be known for, is having technical chops, but understanding how people like yourself would use it. If we can see around the corner, see the changes coming in the industry, make whatever those changes are in here, married with the way that you use it currently speaking, we know that we have, chances are, a customer for life, but we know that we're doing it the right way at the right time.
How does feedback work? A lot of people love MeasureQuick because literally you can just call Jim and be like, Jim, I don't like this. Jim's either tough or else he's like, actually, that's a great idea, and then integrates it.
So we've made changes to this since we've launched based on technician feedback in the field. I'll either notice something where they'll text me or they'll email me or they'll call the office and say, listen, it should do this. They'll send it to me and also our product development team. They'll send it off to our team in France and they'll say, yeah, we could do that. Just give us a couple weeks. And then we spit out, so we were able to double the pump speed. We were able to double the refresh rate on the screen. Yes, double the CO sensor activity time. So we already have the fastest, what's called the T90 time. Yeah. So we were able to even make that even faster. And also other improvements to our own app. So we have obviously our measureQuick, but we have our own app. So we were able to make improvements to our own app. Yep. So we were able to improve, whether it is the measureQuick platform or whether it is our own platform, those improvements can be divvied out amongst those in the space.
Yeah. So you modify the Bluetooth firmware, you introduce new capabilities.
And if we didn't, the biggest thing is taking that feedback in and making those adjustments, because we didn't do that, all this me pontificating that we listen to our brothers and our sisters out there would be untrue. We listen, that's how we're able to get it to where it's at. That's why we're on MeasureQuick, and that's why NCI uses it, is because we listen when we developed, continue to listen now after launch, and we make the improvements as we make them.
What about all those techs out there that they don't see the need for a combustion analyzer yet?
Very simply put, you're not the amazing Kreskin. My bald head is not the magic eight ball where you shake it and says the system is set up correctly. Combustion is like doing blood work on your body. You can look like the picture of health, which I'm sure you do, Ben. I'm sure you're the picture like you're an Adonis. However, internally, something could be brewing. That's where the blood work comes in. Exactly, exactly. That's where combustion comes in. So the blood work gives me the state of your health if I'm your doctor, despite what you might look like. Combustion analysis does the same thing. Gives the state of health of the piece of equipment, despite outward appearances, despite what it sounds like. It says, oh no, CO is high. Eventually, that's going to cause a potential dangerous issue in the space or create an issue with the challenging the components within the system itself to make the system fail prematurely. So you can then make the necessary adjustments, because an analyzer has diagnostic, commissioning and maintenance capabilities, as well as a seal monitor and doing gas pressure. So for commissioning, equipment's new. We think it's plug and play. It is not. You're putting systems in mutually exclusive environments that are different from one to the next. You have to tailor its performance to the environment. Different fuel pressures, different static pressures, different everything. Every system is different. You got to set up your heat transfer. All this information can be done via an analyzer like this.
That's amazing.
So commissioning, diagnostics, and maintenance, and those are what I call the big three.
Yeah. And the consequences of not having one of those in your gear,
which is huge, because you have liability issues. So if you, with a combustion analysis, you have proof of the way you left that piece of equipment. So you were able to show its state of health the way that you left it. Something happens after you leave, that's not on you. So you have that proof. Right, exactly. So you have that proof. So there is no question. So it saves you from liability, but it also is the better thing to do for your customer. If you want to have this be your career and not just a job, you have to do and give your career the respect it's due. Use the appropriate tools with the proper technology. Do your job correctly. Do the diagnostics. Run the analyzer on the system. See where you're at. And then you can position yourself with whatever kind of adjustments you need to make. So it's a crucial piece across all those peripheries.
It was a very polite guilt trip.
I try to do what I can. You know, sometimes you need therapy, sometimes you don't, but I try to do what I can.
Tough love is important.
It's a little Jedi mind trick to say, hey, Ben, you have to test. So, there you go.
I have to test.
Right?
Awesome. Thanks, Tyler.
Thank you, Ben. Appreciate you very much.
Yeah.